Blackstone Audio presents Kaffir Boy, the true story of a black youth's coming of age in apartheid South Africa, by Mark Mathabane. This book is dedicated to those handful of white South Africans who helped me grow as a human being and a tennis player, and with whom I share the hope of someday seeing a South Africa free of apartheid. And to Stan and Marjorie Smith, who believed in me and gave me a new lease on life by providing me with the opportunity to realize my dream. A very special dedication goes to my family and to millions of my black brothers and sisters who still remain slaves in the prison house of apartheid. To them, for teaching me to fight and to be a survivor, I chant, Amandla! Away to! Power is ours. Let us not rest until we are free to live in dignity in the land of our birth. Preface. I am always asked to explain what it felt like to grow up black under South Africa's system of legalized racism known as apartheid, and how I escaped from it and ended up in America. This book is the most thorough answer I have heretofore given. The last thing I ever dreamed of when I was daily battling for survival and for an identity other than that of inferiority and fourth-class citizen, which apartheid foisted on me, was that someday I would attend an American college, edit its newspaper, graduate with honors, practice journalism, and write a book. How could I have dreamed of all this when I was born of illiterate parents who could not afford to pay my way through school, let alone pay the rent for our shack and put enough food on the table, when black people in Alexandra lived under constant police terror and the threat of deportation to impoverished tribal reserves? When, at 10, I contemplated suicide because I found the burden of living in a ghetto, poverty-stricken and without hope, too heavy to shoulder. When, in 1976, I got deeply involved in the Soweto protests, in which hundreds of black students were killed by the police, and thousands fled the country to escape imprisonment and torture. In Kaffir Boy, I have recreated, as best as I can remember, all these experiences. I have sought to paint a portrait of my childhood and youth in Alexandra, a black ghetto of Johannesburg, where I was born and lived for 18 years, with the hope that the rest of the world will finally understand why apartheid cannot be reformed. It has to be abolished. Much has been written and spoken about the politics of apartheid, the forced removals of black communities from their ancestral lands, the influx control and pass laws that mandate where blacks can live, work, raise families, be buried, the migrant labor system that forces black men to live away from their families 11 months out of a year, the breaking up of black families in the ghettos as authorities seek to create a so-called white South Africa, the brutal suppression of the black majority as it agitates for equal rights. But what does it all mean in human terms? When I was growing up in Alexandra, it meant hate, bitterness, hunger, pain, terror, violence, fear, dashed hopes and dreams. Today, it still means the same for millions of...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.